Tony, GG. Well, GG, Tony. Hello, friends. My name is Brandon Dayton. I'm your humble narrator, and welcome back to Rust. Part number 8, if I do recall correctly. Our helicopter base has mostly been made of scrap metal. I did miss a patch on the roof that I just noticed. And right now we're standing on top of a scout tower, which is my own construction, and this is all scrap metal. The first three or four doors are like honeycombed. First three or four floors are like honeycombed with doors. Not like honeycomb, they are. I've set up a lot of defensive tool cupboards, which are just sealed in with scrap metal. There's a couple on that I had to put on the outside, which are armored. And then we've also got our little quarry all surrounded and also unable to be built over, which is pretty freaking cool. Down here we have all three beds for my comrades, and I need to put some more stuff in here, rifles and whatnot, but I did try to leave some armor, and we can split that up as need be, I suppose. And then there's easy way down. I was gonna put some stuff in the cage. Really, if I can get some slaves, I'd like to bring them up here. It would be the thing to do. And then this is basically so we can get down easily. I've positioned all these things perfectly, so you'll take minimal damage. I did take a little bit there, but two floors is basically the max. So I had to build this thing as well, and then you drop off on this side. Boop! I lost about 15 damage going down there, as per usual, as I do. So I finally figured out how to build a rocket launcher, which is the one thing that I've really, really been wanting to do more than anything else. I'm super, super excited. So I'm cooking up some sulfur, and hopefully we can make some gunpowder combined with explosives, and we'll see what this rocket launcher do. I have a lot of C4, a lot of C4, so I'll probably bring some of that with me as well. We're gonna go all fucking Rambo today. Let's make some gunpowder, I think. We need more charcoal. More charcoal. Where could I get some? In somebody's house, probably. That's a pretty good way to get some charcoal. Really, I don't care what I find in the houses. I just want to have a little look-see. There's a little more charcoal. It'll do. Wonderful. Good amount of gunpowder. Couple metal fragments. I can make a whole shit ton of stuff now. I don't know how to make hollow sights, but the 4x zoom is pretty tasty, even on the assault rifle, as long as you just like tap, tap, tap. There is no auto fire at long distances, but that's what the laser sight's for, mostly. So I'm really liking my build and my character. Obviously, I've changed up my toolbar somewhat, which is different from the last episode. This is all armored, which is different from the last episode. I put a few additional doors and things like that. Yes, we are doing the fucking thing. Okay, so, I've got some of this and some of that. We should make some explosives, I think. How do I make a rocket? Please tell me. 80 metal fragments, 10 explosives. Okay. 80 metal fragments, 10 explosives, but you also need 150 gunpowder. So, let's see if I have any explosives lying around in my secret chest. The secret chest of Dayton, which of course is separate from everybody else's because I did the most work on the base now. I have a giant thing. Oh man. Alright, we can make probably one explosive. I'm gonna bring, let's bring 10 of these. 10 of these little fellas. Which would be sad to lose, but there's so many more. I've been doing so much work, and I don't know if you guys noticed all the water barrels and shit like that, but we definitely have enough water to last us. Got a few med kits in there. I guess I need to make at least one explosive. One explosive, which is gonna require metal fragments, and then I can make a rocket. A fucking rocket! High velocity rocket, incendiary rocket. I think just a regular rocket is going to be just fine. And then we need 10 more explosives to do another one. Ah, rockets are quite costly, aren't they? Well, it's a good thing that I have a few that I saved up from previous, like, airdrops and things like that. Could make probably some more explosives, but I don't know if it's going to be enough. So we'll just drop that in there. Good amount of gunpowder. Oh yeah, that's what I want. Look at it! It's so good! Oh. This is gonna be a lot of fun. Okay, so I do have my PvP gear, metal face mask, metal chest plate, road sign kilt. I don't know if they're metal leggings, but then I also have my miner's hat. Since I don't have a flashlight attachment, I could make it, but I'm hoping to get the silencer. That's the other thing I can't make, holosight and silencer, which I guess I could just trade for. Ask somebody if they're up to just lend me one, and then I can spend some blueprint fragments on that, since I got basically everything else I wanted. The rocket launcher was the last thing I wanted. I got it this morning. And I'm ecstatic about that. Oh my god. So I wanted to jump on and show you guys what it do. What it do? Saving up all this canned food. I'll just eat some chickens. That'll recover health nicely. Alright, so what do we need? What don't we need? I need to drop the ore fragments. Little raw chicken. Oh, there's code locks in there. What a random assortment of things. I probably do need this if we're gonna do some raiding. I should definitely collect some woods. And that'll do. I might end up throwing away the builder's hammer at some point, since I don't want to be a dick and, like, make stone things and have them use C4 on their own base to, like, fix their base. That's fucked up. I'll just blow the door off. When you log back in, you can put a new one on. No harm, no foul, right, bro? I did scout out a few places, which I will point out on the map. And I did meet a few new people as well. So it's a pretty friendly server, all things considered. But as to be expected in Rust, there's quite a bit of backstabbing and such as well. But also, you know, most people are nice. They're not going to slap their doors on your base. And if they do, hopefully they'll give you the code lock. That would be quite generous of them. I've tried to build bridges around, but failed miserably most of the time. So, I do have one on each side of my base that kind of functions from when I was putting up the tool cupboards and such. Oh my god. Can I get out of the water? Get out of the water! but yeah. I also broke a part of my base as I was trying to build up the side and cover up some scrap metal shit. Or cover up some stones with scrap metal. No matter. I'll just run up the north side here of this mountain. And we'll see if we can't get into some trouble. I kind of want to kill a piggy with a rocket launcher, but those rockets are so expensive to make that I better just use it on a base. We'll use some C4 or something on a base. Maybe something that's a little decayed so we know these people aren't going to be back. That would make me feel a little bit better about it, because people work really hard on their shit, and then to just come by and be like, oh, gonna blow it up now, it is kind of a dick move, and I feel bad about it. But the mystery is just too much. I can't help myself. I need to explore what you have for me in your house. I'm not gonna pick up stones or anything like that unless we pick up a bunch of wood in somebody's house or something like that. But I don't know. I'd go for like ammo first, obviously. Ammo and explosives and rockets. And maybe guns, because I'm kind of greedy like that. Even though we have an entire box of guns in our base, I know how to make basically everything. We've got like flamethrowers and all kinds of crazy shit. But it's just a good time. Hoarding is a good time. And, you know, it's relatively easy to start back up, even if somebody completely loots your shit. So, I guess you can't feel too bad in Rust. It's just how it goes sometime.
Just how it go.
Is that a bear? I thought I saw a bear in the bush. It's a berry bush. Nope. Nothing puffin'. Alright. So we should be coming up on the Rad Town relatively soon. There's quite a few structures that I scouted out. And I want to have a little look-see. If there be anything inside. Oh, I'm too fat for this. Nope, I'm too fat. Damn it! Why did I have to eat all that boar meat? Because it was delicious. By the way, it's called pork. It's not just boar meat. Is it different? I don't know. I'm really unsure. Alright, this is relatively off to the side. The Rad Town should be coming up soon. There is a base. I just spotted it. It's not quite to the Rad Town, but they seem to have a little bridge across the river. Unfortunately, the base doesn't seem to be complete, so I don't think there will be that many resources inside. But we should have a little peek. I think it would behoove us. Let me have a little hide right here while I check the map. I always get really nervous when I'm doing naughty things. But being naughty is so much fun! Alright. They don't have window bars or anything like that. We are gonna have to use a couple C4 to blow down that door. There's also a back door. And yet a third door. That looks like a salvage shelf right there. So I guess we can try our luck. And hope nobody logs on just in the nick of time, which is something that happened the last time I tried this. Oh my god, I suck so hard. Alright. I won't fuck with it anymore. I'm not really even that interested. It doesn't look like a fully formed base. But no worries. No worries. Maybe we can find some other shenanigans to get into. And if I haven't used up all the C4 on the way back, then I definitely will take the opportunity to do so. Hooray! Hooray! I should have just gone for a door. I mean, yeah, I don't know why I thought there was a salvage shelf back there. But I don't want to use any more C4 on the sheet metal walls just to get through. Or maybe I do. I don't know. It's hard to say, anyway. It is relatively well protected from the bottom, which makes me think there might be a treat. But no matter. No matter. We must carry on. And I should be heading towards the Rad Town. What do I spy with my little eye? I think it's just over this ridge. And there are a couple of structures near it. Again, just a little bit of scouting. Where would be a good place to put? Yeah, like that right there. It's going to take some ingenuity, I think. But that's no problem, because they haven't put a building blocker up. It looks like somebody had the same idea I did. But we'll see just what it holds. A little bit of wall, a little bit of wall, a little bit of wall. And then I get some stairs. Some stairs. L shape? Is that gonna work? Yeah, sure, whatever. Hello? Anybody in here? Can I get back up if I go down there? I guess I can. Okay. Anything in here? Nothing, it seems. Oh, there's some decay. And that'll make it really easy to get in, actually. I'll only have to waste one C4 for this. I gotta place it correctly. There. That'll do. I think it's 10 beeps. Did I just screw myself? How do we get out? Oh no! I'm gonna have to blast my way out. It's the only way. Alright. How about this? That's so fun. Kablooey! Kablow! Inside of your house now. Not quite. But there's a lot of chests in there. If I could just, do a little something. Jump crouch? Jump crouch! Jump crouch! Yeah! No problem. Yeah, somebody beat us to this shit. I'm gonna authorize myself. Anything in here? Bone fragments? Nothing. Bunch of foods. Oh, look at this. Salvage cleaver. That's pretty cool. Not worth a couple C4, but I'll take it. Wooden ladder. Yeah, I like that. I know how to make them, but I need some cloth to do so. A little bit of ore for my troubles. Don't mind if I do. It's like such a tiny hall. Whatever. Let us see what lies up this way. Somebody certainly beat us here, probably. Tony, GG. Well, GG, Tony. I did find somebody. Somebody to love. Can anybody find me? Somebody to... Well, I think that'll do. And now I got the key for the front door, so I don't have to blow my way out again. Take his metal face mask just so he knows. Dayton does was here. But I ain't gonna kill him. And I hope he don't wake up. Hello, world! Well, that was fun. Let's do some more. I got 5 more C4. I did see that little thing, and if it has a door on it, I might have a peeky. A peeky-weeky. Poor Tony GG. I'm sorry, Tony. I didn't kill you, though, so you can rest assured. Or something. Not rest assured. Somebody was just inside your fucking house and stole all your stuff, but it's okay. It was your friend Dayton Does. Don't worry. It'll all go to good use. Ooh, here's some cloth. Gotta love that hemp. And then they also hot patched shit, so Yeah, you get seeds from hemp now. You can start your own hemp farm.
Ooh.
That's cool. I want to do that. Said nobody. Oh yeah. Somebody been up in there.
Hello, hello.
I can't build. That's quite ingenious of them. Well, somebody got there first. That's all I know.
That's all I know.
Let's see if I can't pinch that other base. We'll just clear out people that don't belong. Don't belong on this side of the map. You heard me?
Did you heard me?
This is my side of the map. People gonna learn. People gonna learn, one way or the other. I think I do have to cross this fucking river. Oh, but there's a pumpkin. Eat the pumpkin. Oh my god, I got so much stuff. Guns I don't even need. But I'll take them. You're fucking right, I'll take them. If I don't get anywhere in this base with 5C4, I should just, fucking lob a rocket. Oh, the rockets can break doors and shit too. So, maybe that's not the best idea. There's a pony over there. Pony, pony. Let's see how it goes. I bet it's a lot denser in there than I think. There is a lot of shit on there. So let's, step away from the door. Explodies. Pardon me. Pardon me, lads. Oh. A little more. Don't mind if I do. Cloth. This is certainly not like a main base or anything like that. I bet that's where the tool cupboard is, so I'm not gonna bother blowing that. Anybody up here? If somebody goes sleepy, maybe they have good thingy. Good thingy for Dayton do. Oops. That's right, climb up and out. I'm glad they have lattice too. That's so convenient. Okay. Doesn't seem like there's much in here at all. I could go up, but I ain't gonna. I'll take my goods and be on my way, sir. Goodbye, sir. Oh. But I do want to do this. For funsies. The rocket is really hard to aim. I guess you gotta use it more like a mortar or something from longer distances. More upward aimy. I think I did have myself right on it, so that's fine. Oh man, that was like not worth it at all, but it's just, it's the principle, you know? You get to peek inside of somebody's house and you go, wow, you got a good layout. Or, wow, that's pretty horrible. What happened? Why did you build your house this way? There's no tool cupboard. I can just build right over the wall. But they don't listen. They just don't listen. They ain't never gonna learn, boy. Am I stuck on like a little thing? Yeah, I am. Yeah, I am. Well, it was a nice little outing. That's for sure. I want to build up some more rockets and some more C4. And there's some bases in the northwest that I'll basically have to commit to. I'd really like to bring some more people with me to share in on the haul. So I'm not trying to bring all this shit back by myself. Because even though I didn't get that much stuff, I did get enough that, yeah. It's filling up my inventory. Just a little bit. Like that, see? Now my inventory's all full, man. How could you do this to me, man? I guess I could get rid of the house key and shit. But it's just a memory of our fun times together. Me and Tony. And a big thatch house that I shot a hole in with a rocket. Oh man. Why would I do that? I just don't... I get the explosives in my hands and something wild takes a hold of me. I don't know what to say. You try looking down the barrel of a rocket launcher and not pulling the trigger. It was so awesome. I want to hit animals with it now. That's the next step. Alright, I'm gonna break up this sulfur rock. I need more sulfur. Actually, yeah, we could get some high quality metal too. High quality metal! And I get 32 for that? That's so amazing. Give me more! 32 more, and I'll feel like the trip was worth it. Because really, high quality metal is the most rare resource when you're playing on 10 stack. It's the most rare resource on regular ass Rust too, from what I can discern. Just because, you get so few. You get one or two, at the most. But when you got, like, mining level up shit, look at my shit. Level 50 mining, I think I get like 1000% bonus or some shit like that. It's just crazy. I don't understand how it got this far. I'll be so sad when the server resets, man. I'll tell you that much right now. It's gonna be bad. Well, filled up on stones already. I'll just take so many. So many stones. Kidney stones. Could I get some more sulfur? Oh, you bet I could. You bet I could! That'll make the trip feel like it was worth it. Really, C4 only costs, about 3,000 sulfur to craft, so a stack of sulfur ore, and you're basically back where you was. Although I did waste, like, 4 C4, so... Yeah, I need a little more than a stack, but... Whatever. It's good adventure time. At the very least. Ooh! No. I was hoping for more sulfur. It was not to be. I should build a little foundation across here. If I could. If I could, then I would. About like that. More. 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 Hooray! Yes! All the way! Nicely. That's a good use of your time. I should try and do it in this one as well, but I think it's a little bit deeper. Is it deeper? No, it's cool. Oh shit! I'm drowning! I fucked it up. Let's try this again. If it's possible. And I'm not sure if it is. Yeah. I just derped. Started running too fast. You gotta stroll. Stroll on this motherfucker. Okay, that'll work. I don't need the last one, I don't care. I'm there already. So I feel kinda bad peeking in people's bases, doing some things. But it's okay. There's much more play to happen. And then I'll really be mackin'. God damn, it's too early in the morning for me to start doing that. It's too early in the morning for explosions. Who said that? Some guy in Pulp Fiction? He was a boxer. I thought it was a real man. Then he said something about he didn't like war, and I was like, man, you gotta love war. It's what kept civilization going. Kind of. In a way, not really. Hey, Piggy. Oh my god, should I? Should I? What a waste. That's so fucking funny, dude. Oh, and all I really take from his body's animal fat. I'm so sorry. I'll see you later. That is so funny. I don't know why I would have an impulse to do that. Yes, I do. Because it's awesome! Can I put this in the water? In the agua? No. It's too deep. Too deep for you, bro. Oh god. Then I'm gonna drown! Because of my own... something. Oh god. If I could just... underwater construction. Underwater welding crew. Here we go. Yeah, place it. Yeah, place it good. That kind of works, doesn't it? Until that point. Whatever. I fucked it up. It'll rot away in a couple days. Oh, speaking of rot, I need to check on my gates. I didn't, make myself privy of them upon exiting. But seriously, look at this base. Who's gonna raid this fucking base? This is the town that I was talking about! We made a town! Yes! I've been trying to place more survey charges so I can get, more mining machines out here, but it doesn't seem like it's gonna happen. It's unfortunate, and, it's really important to make these outside ones that are right next to the wall armored, because it takes 4C4 to get through an armored wall like this. So that is the most solid construction for your base. Especially if your base is like honeycombed back and forth. If it's just honeycombed with sheet metal, then they can go through the walls pretty easy in basically whatever way they want. If they know where your stairwell is. Oh, also, I think you can get out of my base by jumping on top of this thing and jumping over the wall, which I need to fix maybe, because I do want to trap people in here. I want them to be mine forever! Blah, blah, blah! Yeah, okay. This is metal cooking. I'll cook up some more metal. Yeah, people like that. Mm-hmm. And since it's all separated, it's going to burn faster. But you knew that! Oh, I should also do this one. Do that one right there! Maybe a little more wood. I think that's all the wood I got. Yeah, I didn't do too good on the wood farm in there. No worries. No worries. I'll just burn up some sulfur. More sulfur. More gunpowder. More delicious destruction. For you and me and family. Yeah, that's stacking up pretty nice, isn't it? Already! Already! I guess I should, combine some of this. Combination! There we go. That's nice. I really like that. And one, and two. Be back on our feet in no time, boy. Know what else I should do is take those tiny crappy med kits that guy had and make them good. Hey! Now they're good! How fortunate. Oh, and I got a couple of assault rifles. I guess it was, relatively worth it. I should get to the top of this thing. Could I stick a C4 on that thing? Is it gonna work? I'm just scared I'm gonna put it on the ground, which is probably what's gonna happen. Fuck you, pig! Don't run through my house! Can't control him. Just can't control him. Oh my god. So friends, this has been a little bit of rusting. I do hope that you have enjoyed, and if you do, I hope you will like, comment, and or subscribe. And if you do any of the following, I'll send you an assault rifle. Piece by piece in the mail, so it's legal. It is legal, but only piece by piece. You have to assemble it yourself. So friends, I'll see you in the next one. This has been Dayton Does and his glorious base of destruction. We're cooking up some goodness here. We're cooking up some destruction. Yes! I hope I find a place to use all that, the rest of the C4 that I have before the server wipes. I just get really nervous going out with it. I hope you understand. So I'll see you in the next one, friends. We'll get into some more shenanigans. And until then, bye-bye!
1, 2, 3, 4. Goodbye, goodbye, see you again. Goodbye, goodbye, see you, my friends.